ladies and gentlemen, let me now invite on stage lawyer, politician, and the president of All India Mahila Congress, Ms. Sushmita Dev. Let's welcome her on stage with a huge round of applause.
Hi. As my introduction said, I'm the president of the All India Mahila Congress, and I got that position in 2017. So I got an office in 24 Akbar Road, and the first thing I did is I asked for a vending machine for sanitary towels in the All India Congress Committee office because there wasn't one. So the topic I have today is connected to what I just said. Is what is period poverty and how do we deal with it? I come from a very remote constituency in the state of Assam called Silchar, and I draw from my experiences that as you move from the urban to the rural, I need not go into the figures or I need not go into the percentage, but the reality is management of menstrual hygiene is a challenge for women in the rural. And when I experienced it as a politician, I realized that we have to do something about it. So I started a petition on change.org when GST was being introduced to actually put the taxation of sanitary towels either at zero or the lowest tax bracket. I remember I met Mr. Jaitley. I had a very long discussion with Nirmala Sitaramanji. But they eventually did it. It took them a year and a half to do it. And I kept thinking that why wouldn't they do it if they were actually exempting khakra and bindi from GST and not sanitary towels? So one day, Mrs. Sitaramanji actually came to me in the central hall and she gave me a very, very logical explanation about input tax credit and how the domestic manufacturers would lose out to the Chinese manufacturers and all of that. So I heard her out with all due respect to her, but what I went back, the thought that I went back with is imagine a sanitary towel is actually a necessity for a woman. It's a right to life issue for a woman. It's a right to live with dignity and decency issue for a woman. But the explanation that came from the finance ministry was industry-centric. And that's the problem. You see, that's the problem. And even when I started the petition, I had many people coming to say, are you being funded by Procter & Gamble? You know, is that why you want sanitary towels to be tax-free? Which I found, I was a little taken aback when people would say that. But the idea is, period poverty is when someone has an involuntary biological reaction in the body of menstruation and you don't have access to a proper sanitary towel. It's a real problem. I'll tell you a story. There's a district called Darang in Assam. It's a tribal area. There was this young girl who was obviously using methods or using mechanisms which were not hygienic and had a bacterial problem like Ms. Joseph was speaking about earlier. She kept complaining of pain. This is a true story. She kept complaining of pain and her parents did not pay much attention to it. And then her stomach started swelling. So her parents, you know, they're in like in a tribal area in the jungles, if you like, thought she was pregnant. And because she was not married, they just hushed it up. Eventually, her pain became so unbearable, they had to rush her to the Guwahati Medical College. And when the doctors treated her, she actually had maggots in her stomach because of which her stomach had swollen up. So access to hygienic methods to deal with menstruation isn't easy. It is a real problem. we need policy intervention, one of which is this government eventually did exempt the sanitary towels from the GST. The real issue is, when I think about it, and every time there was a GST council meeting, I used to think, I hope it happens this time, I hope it happens this time. But actually, when I looked at the list of people who attended the GST council meeting, there were no women. They were all men. The only chief minister who could have been in the council is Vasundhara Raje ji, and fair enough, she sent her finance minister who was a man. So we really need to ask ourselves that what is our priority? This is a right to life issue. We need to have a paradigm shift in our heads as a policy maker and make sure that every woman, no matter where she is, that we achieve a last mile delivery, because there will be many more girls like what happened in Narang. It's a matter of priority. We have to give it priority. It's a right to life issue. And I believe that as policymakers, we always talk about women empowerment, but there are very few things that we do which actually has a real impact. So, for instance, my time is up. A ASHA worker is responsible for distributing a pack of sanitary towels at the rate of 6 rupees. It's a government scheme. But her incentive is only 1 rupee per packet. So the question is that incentive enough for her to actually carry that sanitary pad across to the villages, to the jungles, to the hills, to the mountains, to the women? It's not. So period poverty is a reality, and I believe that the way to overcome it, is to have better policy interventions. Just one last thought before I step down is, I went to the World Bank in a delegation of parliamentarians, and they told me how taxation is a very important way to discourage people from consuming sin goods. So the converse should apply, and I believe that all the states who have actually gone ahead and given free sanitary towels to women is an excellent fiscal policy which I believe every state should implement, and that will help. And to end it on a lighter note, Khushbu talked about discrimination in politics and all of that. I've never had a Me Too moment, I'll be honest. And I actually come from a family of 6 members, and all of us bleed except my father, because we are 4 sisters and my mother. Thank you very much.